through the process of actually using a belt tensioning gauge to set the proper belt tension or deflection amount on this V-belt. Now, there are a lot of ways you can find that information. Usually your belt tensioning gauge comes with a table. Based on the size of the belt and the horsepower and things, you can calculate how much deflection you have. I use an app called Browning Toolbox Technician. It's a free download that you can use. You can find charts and tables online, but basically you have the two things you need to set. Deflection force, how hard you press on the belt, and deflection distance, how far the belt deflects or bends when you push on it. So a belt tensioning gauge is used to measure, obviously, belt tension. Two things that you need to set. One is the deflection force, or how many pounds of pressure we put against the belt to make it deflect. The other one is the deflection distance. Distance is measured here, and there are a couple of different ways to do this. So using the large O-ring to set the amount of deflection in inches, I can use the inches scale if I know how much the belt is supposed to deflect. If you don't know that, you can also use this inches of span length. Let's just say the two shafts, the motor shaft and the fan shaft, are 40 inches apart, center to center. I would just roll this O-ring up, align it to the dot for 40 inches, and that will set my span length. So what I would do now to measure the deflection force, I would hold the rubber tip, put the pointed end onto the belt, and push it until I get this deflection distance. And then I would just read the amount of pounds of force that I'm using to get the belt to deflect the proper distance. So I've already done the calculations, and I've found out that for this belt, it's an A-size belt with shiv diameters the size they are, the center span distance from shaft to shaft, and horsepower of the motor tells me that I need 0.38 inches of deflection, let's just say a third of an inch or 3/8 of an inch, and I also need 2.21 pounds, or about 2 pounds of force. Now, I have adjusted this just by feel. We're going to see how close it is. Now, there's a couple of ways you could do this. I could make a mark on the machine here and deflect that. If I had two belts, I could actually use one as the control or the reference and measure with that one. In this case, what we're going to do is pull a string across here. We just want to give ourselves a reference so we know how far this belt deflects or bends when we push down on it. So I've set my proper deflection distance for the belt, which is about 0.3 inches, about a third of an inch. What I'm going to do is press this here. I pull this orange string across as my reference mark. I'm going to press here somewhere in mid-span of the belt. What I want to see is actually how much deflection force I'm putting on it to get the proper distance. So I'm going to push down here until this black O-ring aligns with this orange string. And when I do, it tells me that I am putting about a pound and a half of force on here. It calls for 2.2 pounds, so my belts are just a little bit loose. I'm going to tighten them up just a little bit. So now I've adjusted the belt tension to get a little bit more tension because these were a little looser than they should be. And now I'm going to recheck it with the gauge. And remember, we're shooting for about a third of an inch of deflection distance and 2.2 pounds of deflection force. I'll press down. And now after adjusting, I am just over 2 pounds of deflection force. We were shooting for 2.2, so now we have a properly tensioned belt. Not just using your thumb, but using a belt tensioning gauge.